Hey, what's up, guys? In the studio, I have a new 4K TV hiding in plain sight. Can you find it? Okay, so I guess it's right here. It's not super hidden, but check it out. This is the new Samsung The Frame TV for 2022. It's QLED, it's matte display, looks just like a picture frame. I know a lot of people nowadays who kind of want to hide their TV in their living room or wherever, so this might be a great option to consider. Let me show you how we set it up and some of my favorite features. Let's get it unboxed, see what's inside, and get it hung up. All right, so I'm gonna mount it here on the wall. It's gonna be a perfect spot, but I think those cubes just need to get bumped up a little bit so that it can fit in that perfect framed up spot. I also got that white border frame to go around it to make it look even more like a picture frame here on the wall. That's gonna look so cool with the matte display. Nice matte black. I think I'm gonna try the feet mounting first and then we're gonna wall mount it next. That way you guys can kind of see which setup might work best for you. So here's what's also included in the box. We got the feet here, remote and cables. What's cool is just this one thin, small little cord goes down into the brains of the system, I believe. So that's really cool. And then here's the wall mounting kit. Come along on the journey and I'm sure we'll figure it out and it won't be too hard. All right, so they say to put it flat down on a padded table or something. I don't have a table big enough, but I got these two things that should be soft. Let's go ahead and place it face down, then we can click in the legs. There's actually two little heights that you can set for these guys. You can flip this guy up if you want a little bit taller. Nice click. Whoa, okay, that matte black display looks so sweet. Estimated yearly cost, only 21 bucks, can't beat that. Love a good peel. Ah! All right, first impressions. This thing looks so matte. It's super cool display. I can't wait to turn it on. Super thin bezels. We got matte black border, matte black feet. Those things are really clean and minimal. I love that they put their little Samsung logo on the side there. It's not on the front like most companies do. It's super strange seeing a TV without all the HDMI and all the other ports on the back because it's all gonna be in that little central hub there. All right, check it out. We got it feet mounted on the TV stand. It looks good. 65 inches is a great size. It could almost work here with these little cube squares, but I mean, come on, it's a frame TV. It's gotta get wall mounted. So check it out. I just unboxed the controller and I'm totally geeking over this remote. It's uber thin, minimal, love the white design. I thought this was a little magnet strip on the back, which I love magnet mounting, but there shows this little sunshine. I think this is actually solar rechargeable, which seems amazing. And USB Type-C if you want to recharge that way. Well done, Samsung. This is probably the coolest little TV remote I've ever seen. This is the super sleek connector that goes from the TV down to the brain so that you don't have all these other cables running up and down your wall. It is super small and minimal. And I think you can even paint this to match your wall color to blend it in if you want. You got your HDMIs, eARC, LAN, optical audio, all the cool connectors there. The One Connect cable, I love when they make it dummy proof. It's labeled TV right on there. And then easily you can route that cable down these channels, left, right, or down. So I got the One Connect hub all connected up. Got the remote here, let's pull the tab and power it on. Ready? Boom, and pop. Here we go, I'm excited. Ooh. The frame secured my Nox. That's awesome.
Experience state of the art with the frame.
Hey, that's the built-in speakers. Okay. Samsung S22 Ultra. Let's do the smartphone quick and easy setup. Oh, and they got a nice calming music going on. I like this.
Stress-free.
Secured by Nox, Samsung. Hope this music isn't copyrighted. And a solar recharger built in the back. That's so cool. You can just hang it out right there next to your window and you always have a full charge on your remote.
You can sunbathe for a little bit.
That's right, sunbathing remote. Smart things, it automatically popped up, connecting to your screen. Name your device, Samsung Frame 65. All done, enjoy your Samsung TV, yes. Get out, there's like no reflections on this thing. Automatically playing NBC News, that's crazy. When setting up a new TV, I always go right to YouTube and do like a 4K sample footage just to see how that clarity and the blacks and all that. Jacob and Katie Schwartz, their stuff is actually really good. Whoa. 2160p, 60 FPS, HDR. Wow, look at that sharpness. You can count those blades. Built-in speaker's pretty good too. Oh, that thing looks like it's actually on my TV. That's hilarious. Guys, just check out how many bright studio lights I have going on in here. And these colors and contrast and everything looks still so good on this TV.
Wow.
Love the HDR QLED. Amazing. And the anti-reflections. I mean, again, look at all those bright lights. You can barely see it reflected in this matte display. All right, now this is art mode. I'm super excited about this. This is what we see in all the viral videos and stuff. We can set different galleries and featured artwork. Preview, free trial. Oh, acquire artwork, $20. No way. Preview, oh, these are all. Okay, that's kind of lame. I was hoping there'd be a lot of free galleries. I guess let's just do preview. Well, that looks cool though. Complimentary, that's free, right? Maybe a soft little crackle, that's cool. This would be amazing if you had like a doctor's office or a waiting room or something like that, have one of these things, that would be impressive. The sharpness and clarity looks good, and again, I love that matte display. No reflections. All right, it's day two, and we are gonna wall mount the TV. Now, you saw how good it looks with this clean and minimal stand, but we are gonna go ahead and move those cubes up, get it wall mounted, kind of check out how that process goes, and then put the frame around the edges to see how it looks like an art piece on the wall. There's multiple different colors available, which is cool. I chose white. See that white border? That is gonna look cool. Step one, I gotta take down some of these cubes as the TV's gonna go up a little bit and then against the wall. I just thought if I raise up some of the lower ones, well then the uppers probably need to go up. So let's go ahead and take down this light stand too. I don't think I really need it. Just make this whole area kind of fresh, new, and clean. All right, and check it out. I finished my new little cube layout. I think it looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and center up the TV, wall mounted right beneath the cubes. And step one, put on these little stickers. All right, there we go. Good enough. For assembly, I always like when they label some parts and pieces. It makes it go just a little bit easier. Next, we screw in these little brackets, the back of the TV. Next, it wants us to attach these little foam pads. Now, there is a way to mount this thing either tighter to the wall or have a little bit more of a gap if you want more of a gap. They have slightly thicker pads to put together. It's nice to have that option. I'm going to go ahead with the thinnest option, get it up and as tight as possible to the wall. There we go, stick on the foam pad, one on each side. Once we have that cable snugly clicked into there, they actually include this cool little plug here, no screw needed. Just pop that in there to secure it. Check it out, I thought this was kind of neat. Here's our little mounting guide. And they have the different dashes for dimensions for spacing. So we've got the 65 inch, we line up the line and the arrows, tape it together. And that is our guide for screwing in the two brackets. All right, I got the template attached to the wall, leveled and set. If you don't have a laser level, you gotta get one. I got this one on Amazon. Of course, all links down below. The ultra thin mounting system is pretty cool. Here's the plate that goes onto the wall. It's super thin, gonna go right there. Then these little guys bend out and there's a hook right there. Bam, easy peasy, gonna lay nice and flat. It's a pretty cool design. All right, laser level helps again. We go ahead and sit on that bottom line and it is perfect. You can kind of nudge the screen up and down just a hair to kind of get it perfect. And magnets kind of help snap it on, which is super cool. Snap on the top piece, final piece. I gotta do a little bit of patching and stuff like that, but
ooh.
It's really interesting seeing like a bright, vibrant video picture on a white framed screen. You just never see that before. Nice. Now that is true 4K HDR.
Really,
look at that.
Looks pretty with the white.
Yeah, the white just looks amazing. That's cool. I've never had a picture frame TV like this and I really dig it. Well done, Samsung. It really is kind of a masterpiece how close we can mount it onto the wall. No wires, cables hidden. Okay, so mine is actually hiding behind that plan, but if you didn't know that, it looks pretty good. I got the Sony A5000 soundbar matched with their SW3 bass and then also their new wireless rears with built-in battery. The sound is jamming in this space. Being Samsung and a smart TV, there's a lot of cool smart features built right in. Let me show you a couple of my favorites. Now, firstly, of course, we can just Chromecast from our computer or phone or whatever over to the TV, stream your YouTube, cast, whatever. Now, I'm a big Samsung SmartThings user. My whole smart home is controlled with SmartThings. And it integrates really well with this TV. Check it out. You can use your phone as like a wireless remote control for your TV, which is really cool. Play, pause, volume, D-pad. We can swipe left and right on the TV, and that's pretty cool. Nice controls. volume, play, pause, all that. So check it out. You can do like video calls and such if you wanted to. This is called camera sharing. This is really interesting. So check it out. Look, there I am. There's just a short little delay. So there's a lot of different unique camera things that you can do. Now this is probably the coolest thing or my favorite thing with the art mode. Now they have the built-in art things, but you can pay monthly, and I'm not a big fan of that membership, and there's just a couple freebie options, but thankfully we can easily send over our own images that we download from wherever. So you can do your family pictures, or check this out. For my computer, I downloaded a few art pieces. All right, so we selected some of the photos from my gallery, and voila, now check this out. This is pretty cool. So look at, we got the Last Supper on here. It auto did this little framing on here, which makes it even look more like a picture frame. You can change the framing effect, colors. Let's go ahead and give it a black border. You can add little effects. Let's say we want to make this photo look like it was done in ink. Takes a couple seconds to process, and there we go. You can set it to slideshow, so then it rotates through all your different gallery photos. There's a few freebies or complimentary pictures that they include. Now, one of my favorites here under classics is this one. Boom, that is so cool. I think the trick is finding images that were actual like paintings or watercolors or something like that, because that texture really comes through on this matte display. And then when you pull out wide, man, look at that. That is just so cool. I got super bright lights in here, but let's go ahead and turn a few off, and man, that just looks so realistic. This is a little annoying and kind of strange. If we try to update, it says current version 1204. Okay, it says we're on the latest version, but if we go on Samsung's website, here's our exact model number, version 1211. So it's like it's not updating correctly over the TV, OTA. We have to manually do it via USB. It's kind of weird. Got the firmware update on the USB drive. Go to software update, date now. You want to search the, search the USB. Yes, date, there it is, 1204. So why that didn't pull OTA? It's kind of a bummer. Software update, 1211. Nice, it worked. So there you go. If over-the-air updates don't push over, you can always download it to a USB drive, and that's a nice backup option, I guess. I'd like to assume that 1211 or future updates would sooner or later come over the air, but I guess I'm not positive. This is really cool. I can actually view my whole smart things on the TV, and then all these automations, I can click Studio One. Ooh, there we go. It turned off, so it's a little delayed, but you can run your automations from smart things on the TV. It's kind of cool. I mean, I think overall, check it out, in this space, it just looks so clean and modern. I love it. Super classy looking, whether you just have an art display on standby throughout the days, or you're watching content. It's a bright, vivid picture display. It just looks amazing. So well done to Samsung. As for pricing, here it is on the website. My 65 inch is currently about $2,000. The white frame borders, they only add on, I think, what, $100-ish dollars. So that's not terrible. I think for that anti-reflective matte display, that slim fit wall mount, all the cool smart features, QLED, for $2,000, I mean, that is definitely a lot of money. But I had multiple friends reach out and say, hey, that wasn't as expensive as I thought it'd be. So it's definitely not for everybody, but it has some really cool, unique features. And for sure, if you get one of these in your home or office or wherever, you're gonna have a lot of people asking questions like, what is that? Where'd you get it? How much was it? It's just a really neat, beautiful TV. So there we go, guys. Huge thanks to Samsung for sending over the unit. All links and everything are down below. I always try to post future updates down in a pinned comment. Check out my other smart home videos here, and I'll see you subscribers in the next video.